Sup all, JC3 here, the baller of YouTube, the general. Welcome to Topic Tackle. My take for today is on how Dirk Nowitzki cemented himself as an NBA legend with a historic 2011 playoff run. First, I gotta say thank you for all the support on the past videos. I appreciate all of you for your feedback in the comments. And if you wanna check out my last video on the one player that Shaq couldn't intimidate, there will be a link in the description. So let's keep this going. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and keep coming in the comments down below. I'm always down there ready to respond to your feedback. Let's get started on this topic. Up until Sunday, June 12th, 2011, Dirk's career was seen as good. I mean, he had won an MVP in 2006-07. He had made many All-NBA teams. He was a consistent 20-plus points per game scorer. He had a near unstoppable one-legged fadeaway shot. He had played all his career for Dallas. And he had some postseason success, so it was fairly good, but not great. Because the one thing that hung over Dirk that hangs over all really good players is that he hadn't sealed that deal yet. And we all know what that deal is, too. And he had come close in 2006. His Mavs were up 2-0 on D-Wade and Shaq, but lost the ensuing four games. Then it got worse for Dirk because his first seed, best record in the NBA, 67-win 2007 Mavs, became one of the few teams in NBA history to lose to an 8 seed in the first round. So Dirk's career started to be marked by failures in the playoffs and his inability to lift Dallas to a title. Fast forward 4 years later to the 2011 postseason, Dirk is now 32 years old, and it's pretty much now or never for him as his prime window is closing. Surrounded by a 32-year-old Sean Marion, a 33-year-old Jason Terry, and a 37-year-old Jason Kidd, Dirk had what we would see as far from a super team. Dallas entered the playoffs as the 3 seed due to poor play down the final stretch of the regular season and would face a surging Blazers team with a young LaMarcus Aldridge and Brandon Roy. The Mavs were favored, but not by much, and they were a popular pick for an upset in the first round. Dirk quieted that noise though, leading both teams in scoring in every game that they won as Dallas beat Portland 4-2. It didn't get easier for Dirk and the Mavs as in the second round, they would have to face the back-to-back champion LA Lakers. In game one, the Mavs had to come back from double digits down in the second half, but it was Dirk again with clutch shots late to earn the Mavs a 2-point victory. From that point on, Dallas had momentum in the series and went on to close out the Lakers in Game 4, famously known for Andrew Bynum's extremely, excessively, extraordinarily poor sportsmanship in that blowout loss. In the Western Conference Finals, Dirk would face a young Kevin Durant, Russell Westbrook, and James Harden, and posted 48 points with 24 for 24 free throw shooting in Game 1. The Mavs would lose Game 2, but would go on to win the next three games to advance to the NBA Finals behind Dirk's 32.2 points per game. No one on the Thunder could guard him as Dirk posed a matchup problem as a big with a jumper that Ibaka or anyone else they put on him couldn't defend. As noted by Dirk's 55.7% field goal shooting during that series and 96.7% shooting from the free throw line, he got there often and cashed in. Now we move on to the biggest stage in basketball where both sides had something to prove. LeBron James had all the pressure on him due to the fact that he was playing in his first finals with the Heat, and Dirk had carried Dallas this far with some 3-point shooting help from Terry and Kidd, and solid play from Marion, Barea, Tyson Chandler, and Deshaun Stevenson. But here is why Dirk's 2011 playoff run, and specifically his 2011 NBA Finals, were so impressive. After a fairly easy win in Game 1 for Miami, in which Dirk tore a tendon in the middle finger of his non-shooting hand that affected his dribbling, passing, and catching, Dallas found themselves down 15 with 6:20 remaining in Game 2. Down the stretch, the Mavs went on a huge run led by Dirk's big shots. And yeah, remember his left middle finger with a torn tendon? Yeah, he just only made the game-winning left-handed layup with a torn middle finger. It's no big deal. With the series tied 1-1, the Mavs would again fall behind in the series, leading up to Game 4. Dirk was awful in the first half, and no one knew what was wrong with him. Remember, Twitter wasn't the go-to spot yet for on-demand news, so 21,000 fans in the arena and everyone watching at home were confused. Come to find out at halftime that Dirk was fighting a 102-degree fever. Maybe that was why he had towels draped on him during every timeout. Dirk's teammates had his back during the game, and when it was clutch time, Dirk caught the ball and drove past Udonis Haslam for the layup that put Dallas up 3 and eventually gave them the edge. Going into Game 5, the narrative got even better for Dirk's legacy. You wouldn't know it now by the respect that LeBron pays Dirk, but back in 2011, LeBron and Wade showed up to Game 5 mocking Dirk's fever with coughing and laughing about how he could be sick in warm weather. Dirk dropped 29 on them with the Jet Terry, pouring in 21 behind him. Game 6 was back in Miami, the always difficult closeout game, especially on the road. Just ask the 2013 Spurs. With the 2-3-2 finals format, Dallas would have to win for the fourth time in Miami, and Dirk made sure it wouldn't be delayed until Game 7. 21 points and 11 rebounds later, don't forget a few more clutch shots down the stretch, Dirk had finally achieved the ultimate goal. Yes, he didn't have the greatest shooting percentage in the finals, but his clutch play down the stretch was legendary. Being the lone all-star on a team with aging role players as the clear underdog against the three-headed monster in LeBron, Wade, and Bosh, that was sure to win not one, not two, not three. Skip to the point, Dirk dominated with 26 points and 9.7 rebounds per game by the end of the series, and again, his clutch performance was ridiculous. To this day, Dirk has been the only one to beat a super team without a star-filled team of his own since the 04 Pistons. Did LeBron choke in this series? Absolutely. But it doesn't take anything away from Dirk's play. Many consider Steph Curry to have choked in the 2016 finals, but no one said LeBron's performance wasn't great because of that. I know that LeBron witnesses might dislike this video, and to that I would say, get over it. This was truly one of the greatest performances that will go down in playoff history by NBA legend Dirk Nowitzki. So let me know what you think in the comments down below. Where does Dirk rank on the all-time power forwards list according to you? Remember to subscribe, like, and leave your feedback in the comments down below, and we'll be back with more Topic Tackle soon. JC3, out!